Everyone knows what a vampire is. You've all heard of them, at least the Hollywood or mythological versions of them. But what about real-life vampires, like real human beings? And surprisingly enough, there's actually a lot of information about this. You just have to get past the glamour and the glitz that is caused by, like, the Twilight saga and similar things that have tried to pick up the leftovers left behind by it. A lot of that stuff actually made it so that real-life vampires were overlooked, and hence, real-life vampires are misunderstood. And I say that they're misunderstood for three main reasons. First of all, real-life vampires aren't spectacular. Second of all, real-life vampires aren't just bloodsuckers. And thirdly, real-life vampires have their own community. Now, my first point. You don't see or hear about people running up walls or turning into bats and flying off. It just doesn't happen. It's not possible. All right? And really, real-life vampires are just ordinary people. There's only one real defining factor, and that is best summed up in a quote by Isildur, a leading vampire community member, in an interview by Ashley Harness. And he said, "A vampire is, quote, someone who requires a supplement gained either through physical consumption of bodily fluids or via direct absorption of metaphysical energy to be able to maintain the balance of their system." Now, that is basically just, they can't produce their own life force, is what they believe, or prana, or chi, which may seem silly, but if you think about it, people have believed in prana and chi for thousands of years when you think of kung fu or the other martial arts or even yoga today. And he says it's not just the consumption of bodily fluids, it can also be the direct absorption of metaphysical energy, which leads me to my second point, which is they're not just bloodsuckers. While some of them do drink blood, those are called sanguarians, and that comes from the term sanguine, which refers to like flesh or red. And there's also a different type of vampire, which is considered a psychic vampire or a psi-vamp. And they absorb it by like contact or just like helping someone who has a strong emotion, like sadness or joy or something. If just being around that person, they believe that they absorb their energy. One explanation for why people think that they may think that drinking blood helps them is anemia, which is an iron deficiency in your blood, which can cause depression and fatigue and stuff, which may think that they're dying or something. And if they drink blood, it'll increase their iron count and therefore make them feel healthier, which may make them believe they're a vampire. As for the psychic vampires, I'm not sure exactly how that works. And my third and final point is not quite related to my first two points, but it's definitely related to my main point, which is that real-life vampires are misunderstood, and that is that real-life vampires have a community, and it's a lifestyle. It's not just like, I want to be a vampire, so I'm going to run around in a cape, and I'm going to file my teeth down into fangs. It's, they actually have a community, and they get together, and they like go bowling or have actually blood drives, which may seem ironic and strange, but they do, they have blood drives. And they have their own websites, and it's kind of like a fraternity or sorority. They have blogs and calendars for them to know what's going on, and they even have like a membership. You can apply for membership and stuff like that, and they have their own system of government, very similar to a fraternity or a sorority. And the biggest problem, stated by Zola Zimmerschild, who is another leading vampire community member, is that they're not taken seriously. In conclusion, frankly, people just don't know about real-life vampires, and that is why they're misunderstood. They aren't evil, and they could be living next to you. You might not even know it. Their age is actually 30 years old. So. You might think that it'd be a bunch of 16-year-old girls, but it's not. Many people claim that they're crazy or confused, and that may be true, but anyone who drinks blood can certainly be a vampire in my mind.